My name is Julie Topoleski, and I am the chief of the Long-Term Analysis Unit in CBO's Health, Retirement, and Long-Term Analysis Division. Each year, CBO issues a set of long-term budget projections, that is, projections of what spending, revenues, deficits, and debt would be for the next 30 years if current laws generally did not change. CBO calls them extended baseline projections. Federal debt held by the public is the amount borrowed by the federal government in financial markets to pay for its operations and activities. Currently, federal debt equals 78% of gross domestic product, or GDP, a very high level from historical standards. As you can see from the chart, debt has exceeded 70% during only one other period in U.S. history, from 1944 through 1950, following the surge in spending that occurred during World War II. Debt is projected to grow sharply over the next 30 years, reaching 144% of GDP by the end of 2049. The rising federal debt is a result of the government running budget deficits. A deficit occurs when spending exceeds revenues. Deficits are projected to grow modestly over the next 10 years, from 4.2% of GDP in 2019 to 4.5% in 2029. After that, deficits increase more rapidly, reaching 8.7% by 2049, an amount only exceeded in 2009, following the last recession. Deficits are rising both because non-interest spending exceeds revenues and because net outlays for interest are increasing. As the figure shows, rising net interest costs add substantially to the deficit. While the primary deficit rises to 3% of GDP by 2049, net interest spending rises to nearly double that amount. This figure summarizes the increases in spending and revenues. Increases in outlays are driven by increases in spending for net interest, the major federal health care programs, that is Medicare, Medicaid, the Children's Health Insurance Program, and subsidies for insurance purchased in the marketplaces, as well as increases in spending for Social Security. Spending growth outpaces growth in revenues, leading to rising deficits. Revenues increase from 16.5% of GDP in 2019 to 19.5% in 2049. Increases in receipts from individual income taxes account for most of that increase. Receipts from other sources increase only slightly as a percentage of GDP. As the figure shows, three factors drive nearly all of the increase in federal revenues. The largest of those is real bracket creep, the process in which, as income grows faster than inflation, a larger proportion of income becomes subject to higher taxes. Revenues also rise because at the end of 2025, certain temporary provisions of the 2017 Tax Act expire. Finally, a tax on high premium health insurance plans, scheduled to go into effect in 2022, accounts for a significant increase in revenues. Total federal spending increases from 20.7% of GDP in 2019 to 28.2% in 2049. As I said before, that growth is driven by spending for net interest, the major federal healthcare programs, and Social Security. The increase is partially offset by decreases in discretionary and other mandatory spending. The increase in spending for net interest is driven by the rise in projected interest rates and by higher debt. The increase in spending for the major health programs and Social Security is driven by the aging of the population and rising healthcare costs per beneficiary. About half of the increase in spending for Social Security and the major healthcare programs results from the aging of the population. Rising healthcare costs per beneficiary drive increases in spending in the healthcare programs. The increasing number of people over the age of 65 boosts the number of beneficiaries in Social Security and the major healthcare programs, particularly for Medicare. The aging of the population accounts for all of the growth in spending for Social Security as a share of the economy, and it accounts for about one-third of the growth for the major federal healthcare programs. The remaining two-thirds of the growth for the major federal healthcare programs is driven by rising healthcare spending per beneficiary. That spending has historically risen faster than GDP per capita, and that relationship continues in CBO's projections. As a result, federal spending for the major federal healthcare programs grows more quickly than the economy. Budget projections are inherently uncertain. Even if future tax and spending policies did not vary from those specified in current law, budgetary outcomes would undoubtedly differ from those in CBO's extended baseline projections. To quantify that uncertainty, CBO examined the extent to which federal debt measured as a percentage of GDP would differ if a set of key factors, several demographic and economic factors, and the growth of healthcare costs deviated from the paths underlying the extended baseline projections. CBO estimates that there is a two-thirds chance that federal debt will be between 71% of GDP and 175% in 2039. That is, debt would probably be higher than it is today. The agency also analyzed the sensitivity of its budget projections to higher and lower values for some of those factors in isolation. For example, even if total factor productivity grew more quickly than in the extended baseline projections, which would result in faster economic growth and lower debt, debt would still be higher than it is today. Likewise, if interest rates were lower than in the extended baseline projections, debt would also be higher than it is today. CBO also examined some alternative policy scenarios. The extended baseline projections are created under the assumption that current laws generally do not change, but other scenarios are possible. CBO looked at two alternative scenarios. The first is an alternative fiscal scenario under which substantial tax increases and discretionary spending cuts would not take place as scheduled, and current law would be changed to maintain certain other policies now in place. Under that scenario, debt would reach 219% of GDP in 2049, compared with 144% in the extended baseline projections. The second is a payable benefits scenario, in which Social Security benefits would be limited to revenues received by the trust funds after the trust funds were depleted in 2032. In that case, debt would be lower than in the extended baseline, but would still reach 106% of GDP in 2049. CBO also estimated the size of changes in spending or revenues that would be needed if lawmakers wanted to achieve some specific targets for federal debt. If the target was debt at its current level, or 78% of GDP, lawmakers would need to reduce the primary deficit by 1.8% of GDP each year. If the target was the 50-year historical average, or 42% of GDP, that reduction would be 2.9% of GDP each year beginning in 2020. If lawmakers wanted to implement those changes later, the necessary reductions would be larger. If you have questions about the long-term budget projections, please send an email to communications@cbo.gov.